I'll be doing question three, budgeting, focusing more on 3.1 and 3.2. Question three, budgeting is for 40 marks. You need to finish it in 30 minutes. The information relates to Sunday Stores Pty Ltd. The business is owned by Adam Stevens. You are required. For 3.1, we have to refer to information B. Let's see what we're talking about. So this will be information B. We have to use information B to identify two items that were incorrectly recorded in the cash budget and two items that are in the cash budget that will not appear in the projected in a projected statement of comprehensive income. You need to understand when it comes to the cash budget, any item will go into cash budget as long as it results in a cash inflow or cash outflow. However, when it comes to the projected income statement, only income and expenses will go to the projected income statement. Whether that income was received or whether that expense was paid, it does not matter. I am going back to that information B and start identifying items that were incorrectly included in the cash budget. Remember, cash budget is all about money received and money paid, nothing else. The first item that I noticed was the discount received under receipts. And when I look at our payments, I see bad debts, that's a non-cash expense, and depreciation is also a non-cash expense. Depreciation is just an imputed expense, same as bad debts. Those are non-cash expenses. So we can't record them in a cash budget because they do not result in money going out. And the discount received did not result in us getting paid the discount. We did not receive money, hardcore cash, in a form of a discount. It is income that we have earned, but we did not receive cash for it. So for 3.1, two items that were incorrectly recorded in the cash budget, it'll be discount received, bad debt, as well as depreciation. You only need to give two. So if you gave three, note that you'll still get 2 marks. You won't get 3 marks. Now we need to identify two items in the cash budget that will not appear in the projected statement of comprehensive income. Remember, the projected statement of comprehensive income or the income statement is all about income and expenses, nothing else. When I look at our income here or our receipts, the only thing that is not income will be cash from debtors. It's money we receive now, but did we earn it now? No. We earned it when those goods were sold. So it is not income right now. It is just cash that we are receiving. The income that relates to that cash was recognized when the sale took place. Similarly, with this payment to creditors, it is not an expense. It is a payment towards creditors, which is a liability. Well, in this case, what counts is, because when it comes to payments to creditors, we might have bought assets. So when we bought those assets, we recognize assets. If we bought expenses, we recognize those expenses when we bought them on credit, not now when we are making a payment. So hence, those two items, they will be included in the cash budget, but they will not be included in the statement of comprehensive income or projected statement of comprehensive income or the statement of profit or loss, i.e., the income statement. 2 marks. Let's go back to the question. 3.2. We need to complete the debtor's collection schedule for December. Let's see what we've been given in the answer book. So this is all we have. I see that we do not need to calculate credit sales. They've already been given to us. And also, collections for November have been recorded, so we don't need to calculate them. We only need to calculate December collections, any monies that will be received or collected in December. And to figure out how much of those credit sales, right? Note that collection from debtors is always calculated from credit sales. So if you're given total sales, remember to only calculate credit sales. So we've been given credit sales, but we need to know how will it be collected. So for us to get that information, we are just going to focus on C. They say credit sales comprise 60% of total sales, but they were given to us. It means that all these credit sales that are given to us here, they are just 60%. So if we want total sales, we will need to take this, multiply it by 100 and divide it by 60. So for each, if you want total sales, you multiply by 100, 100 will be total sales divided by 60, which is your credit sales. So you take that 535,500, multiply it by 100, divided by 60, it'll give you total sales for September. I don't know why they gave it to us. If we were given total sales or cash sales, we were going to use that information to calculate credit sales. Because for us to prepare the debtor's collection schedule, we need credit sales. However, here they were given to us. So that information was not important specifically for this question. And then it says debtors pay according to the following trends. So they will pay 40% is collected in the month of sale. They receive a 5% discount. Meaning that you're going to take credit sales. If you are given credit sales for that month, you are going to take those credit sales, whatever they are, you will multiply them by 40%. And then multiply them by 95%. You won't get 100% of 40%. You will only get 95% of 40%. How did I get this 95%? I just took 100 and I subtracted 5%. You got it. Good. 50% is collected in the month following the month of sale. 8% is collected 2 months after the sale, and 2% should be written off as irrecoverable in the month after the sale. In the third month after the sale. Sorry for that. Everything that they gave us here does actually matter, but we don't care about anything that will be collected whenever. We only care about what will be collected in December. I'm going to start with the September credit sales. 50%, I mean 40% of those sales were collected in September. 50% will be collected in October. 8% will be collected in November. None of those sales will be collected in December. Okay. Let's try the October credit sales. So of these credit sales, 40% will be collected in October. We'll be given 95% discount. 50% will be collected in November. And only 8% will be collected in December. Now that we're going to record it. Of the October credit sales, 8% will be collected in December. We only care about what will be collected in December. Okay, let's start with credit sales for November. 40% will be collected in November. 50% will be collected in December. So we're going to take that 651,000 multiplied by 50% and put it under December. Okay, now the December credit sales. 40% of these sales will be collected in December. But we won't get the full 40%. We are only going to get 95% of the 40%. If you have watched my videos, I warned you never, if you are given the discount, do not subtract it from the percentage that will be collected. So don't just say this will be 682,500 times 35%. That is wrong. When you do that, you are saying that only 35% of 682,500 will be collected. And that is wrong. We are still collecting 40%, but not 100% of 40%. Only 95% of 40% will be collected because we are giving our customers 5% discount. So you will take that 682,000, times it by 40% and times it by 95%. How did I get that 95%? A discount reduces 100% of what will be collected. So it will reduce 100% or 40%. So it'll reduce 100 by 5. So 100 minus 5 will give you 95. And the amount that will be collected in December from those credit sales will be 259,350. To calculate total collections for December, you just add everything up. You will get 636,090. Okay, we good? I have actually posted this paper under in the classroom, Google Classroom, and it's under DBE examination papers. So go there, download it, and try 3.3. In the next video, I will be doing 3.3. For this one, we only did 3.1 and 3.2. Please note that all these videos will be saved under the playlist written DBE examination, November 2023 examination papers. Okay. So you will get all videos that relate to the November 2023 paper 2 paper. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope I made it easy for you. So for now, try 3.3. If you have time, also try out 3.4. Okay, so this is all we've got. This is what we did. So we have already done C, probably there's D, E, and F that needs to be done, okay? And I will leave it there for now. Also, before I say that, please don't forget to share, like, hit the notification button, comment, and subscribe. 合作。